Chuck Mead. I'm the director of LAMP. And LAMP is a very unique program. We're a research program. We're an educational program. We're focused on learning more about the history of our nation's oldest port and the surrounding region of Northeast Florida through maritime archaeology. Maritime archaeology is really one of the few hands-on ways to learn about history. We actually reach out and touch it. Archaeology is interested in the past lives of human beings. Maritime archaeologists are interested in the past lives of humans who have made their lifeways on the sea. At LAMP, we are interested not only in previous generations, but in future generations. A lot of work with students. We have a high school program where we teach local high school students how to dive. We also have college level programs where we have university students come to take a field school here.
We're going to go out to some of the shipwrecks and do sonar imaging.
The past is really unknown, and that's part of the reason why you're trying to find things that you don't know about. You're trying to find clues, and to think that people are resourceful enough to look in the ocean and gather information that's not available, it's just so big and open. I mean, it's endless what you can find.
What to expect? Expect early mornings, lots of hard work, but a ton of fun and something you'll never ever forget.
We learned that the site is a little more covered now than when we looked at it a year ago. This little cluster of wrecks in the area of the site we're working presently all have a sonar record that's up to date to today. So if anything were to happen, like a hurricane were to come through or somebody were to loot the sites, we would have a good record of what's there now. And we've been developing that record over the course of 3 years, so we have an idea of what happens due to storms, due to human interaction, and due to the general nature of the seabed movement and changes. It's a pretty dynamic environment now.
This is one of the most challenging places that we have worked. We are dealing with surprisingly cold water. We're dealing with very low visibility, where often the divers cannot see anything, and our students or our archaeologists are doing their work by braille. We have unpredictable weather. Sometimes we have heavy seas, so our divers, they feel like they're riding bucking broncos on the seafloor. Certainly, the artifact that is the most striking that we have encountered on this shipwreck to date is the cauldron. That was the first artifact that we encountered when we made the discovery of this shipwreck. It immediately made us think that this could be a colonial period shipwreck. When we found other artifacts kind of corroborating that theory, it was time to pull up the cauldron. And of course, that was a very exciting day. This is a cauldron, so it's a piece of cookingware. It could have been from the ship's galley. It could have been a cargo intended to be sold on the markets in St. Augustine at the plaza.
My name is Star Cox, and I'm the archaeological conservator here. The significance of the cauldron is that it narrows down our window of when the date of this shipwreck was. Based on the shape of the handles, the square handles, we know that it was produced sometime between 1740 and 1780. Now that we've raised the cauldron, we made sure that it stayed wet, because once the cauldron hits the surface, the corrosion process accelerates due to the increased oxygen. Now that it's back at the conservation lab, it will go through a slow desalination process, just removing the salt slowly, just through water changes, and then eventually we'll manually remove some of the corrosion from it and then put the whole thing into electrolytic reduction, which forces a current through the artifact that helps remove the remaining chloride that will help clean the artifact.
This object, it promises to lead to more discoveries. It will lend us some insight into how people live their basic everyday lives, to the materials that St. Augustine citizens needed living on the frontier, the kinds of cookware they used. Further analysis might give us an idea of food contents in the cauldron. We can learn all kinds of new things from what this one artifact.
It was exciting. It was, it was the first like real identifiable thing that was down there. And so, it really brings home this isn't just a scatter of random stuff. This is a shipwreck, and we have, people and a past and, culture.
My name is Chuck Mead, Director of LAMP. I want to thank you all for sharing a little bit of your time with us to learn more about our program, the research we do, the impact we have on the local community and the global community. You can always follow along with the latest discoveries we're making out at sea or in the laboratory by coming to our webpage. There'll be more episodes like this one you're watching, so stay tuned. Come visit us at the Lighthouse and stay in touch, see what we're up to.